Hey, welcome back to my studio. If you're new here, my name's Morgan and I make all things party and event. And today I want to show you how to put together this DIY balloon arch frame. There are lots of different styles of arches out there, and I love this one in particular because of its narrow base. If you need something that doesn't take up tons of room, but you still want the height and grandeur of a balloon arch, this is a great one to use. So follow along and I'll show you how to make it. The first part we need to make is the bases of the arch, and this is made from two 12-inch by 12-inch square pieces of 3/4-inch thick plywood. Now you want to make sure you use plywood and not particle board, as that will be much stronger and sturdier for our arch. I cut these to size using a circular saw, but you could always ask your hardware store and see if they'll cut it to size for you. Once I had my two squares cut out, I then primed them with white paint on the top and the sides so they had a nice clean look. To this, we need to attach a 3/4-inch PVC pipe floor flange, and this is what will make it possible for us to join the base to the side pipes in just a little bit. In addition to the flange, you'll need 4 fender washers and 4 1¼-inch long screws, and we're going to center all of this in the middle of our board. So to find that center point, I'm going to take a tape measure or ruler and just line it up with the corners of the board and make an X right in the center. On top of that X, we're going to realign our floor flange so it's nice and centered on that mark, and then I trace the inside of all 4 screw holes, which will act as a guide for our drill bit. I'm pre-drilling all my screw holes using an 1/8-inch drill bit, which is just narrower than the screws I'm using. Then in the center of each of those circles we drew, I'm gonna put a hole that's about halfway down through the plywood. You don't need to go all the way through, as the screws won't reach that far. For the final time, we're gonna align the floor flange on top of the screw holes we just made, and then on top of that, layer on our 4 fender washers and insert all 4 of our screws, tightening them down so they're nice and snug. Do the exact same steps to create the second base, and now these are ready to support our side poles. The sides of the arch are made from 2 5-foot-long sections of 3/4-inch PVC pipe. Now it's cheaper to buy the pipe in a 10-foot-long length and cut it to size using a pipe cutter, but you can also buy these directly from the hardware store in 5-foot lengths. With these 2 pipes cut to size, we can get our final piece of pipe, which will make the top of our arch. And that is this 10-foot-long section of 1/2-inch PEX piping. I chose PEX because it's much more flexible than PVC piping, and that's going to give us that beautiful curve we want at the top of our arch. Across the entire length of my pipe, I've decided to put a mark every 12 inches using a permanent marker. These marks allow me to quickly and consistently change up the sizing of my arch, which I'll show you how to do in just a moment. Now we can finally assemble the arch. So to start off, I've got both of the bases 4 feet apart on center, and into those bases, I'm gonna snugly seat both of my 5-foot lengths of PVC pipe. Once those are secure in the bases, we can then move up and insert our PEX pipe into the top of our PVC pipes. So take one end and insert it down into the PVC pipe until you get to that first mark. For stability and a nice arch, you want to make sure you have at least 12 inches of that PEX pipe down into the PVC pipe. Once those are right where you want it, then wrap a little bit of either duct tape or clear packaging tape around both pipes to secure it in place. Now we're going to move over to the other side and do the exact same steps, only this time I'm going to insert 3 feet of the PEX pipe, or 3 marks, down into my PVC pipe, which means I have a total of 6 feet, creating that beautiful curve at the top of my arch. Then you can just add that final piece of tape over that joint, and this arch is ready to go. If you'd like a set of written instructions to go with today's project, I'll have some digital plans available in the description box below. Now earlier I promised to show you some different sizing, so this is 4 feet wide and 7 feet tall at the moment, but if I nudge the bases so that they're 5 feet apart, and then if I adjust the PEX pipe so that there's only 1 foot of PEX inside each PVC pipe, giving me a total of 8 feet to create that nice curve at the top, that will give me a total arch size of 5 feet wide by 8 feet tall. And now this arch is ready for some light duty decorating, which means balloons or lightweight decorations.
I hope you're inspired by today's project and give this one a try. Having an adjustable frame like this gives us so many possibilities when we're creating decorations for our next party or event. If you enjoyed this video, please consider hitting that like button, subscribing below, and don't forget to check out our Patreon group if you'd like to up your party planning game. So until the next time, you can check out some of my other videos over here. And remember, stay creative, everybody. Bye.